guys, yo, what's up? Sherry here with a highly, highly requested video for you guys. And it is How I Study Korean, updated edition. Because I do have a video about how I study Korean. And I actually still use a lot of the tips that I used in that video. So if you haven't seen it, I'll put it in the description below. Today, I made this whole dang list about how I study Korean. And I'm going to show you guys what I do to study Korean. Disclaimer, I honestly don't know what I'm doing a lot of the time. My studying is not perfect in any way, shape, or form. This is just personally what I do that works for me. So if you hate what I do, I'm sorry, but it's just like what I do to study Korean myself. This is like self-study edition, I guess. This is just totally self-study because I actually love self-studying Korean more than like being in a class, to be honest. So we're just gonna go with it. So yeah, we're gonna start with my two main ways that I study Korean, and the less fun ways, the ways that focus on grammar and vocabulary mostly. So the first number one thing that I do to study Korean is I use Talk To Me in Korean. I have mentioned them so many times in these videos. Talk To Me in Korean is kind of like the best. They have this website, they have a YouTube channel, they have all these grammar lessons, and they just have so much content to help you study Korean. I love them so much. I will put their website and their YouTube in the description below because I use them so much. So what I will do basically with Talk To Me in Korean is I will study a grammar lesson. I'm up to level 4 in their grammar lessons, and I think they have 9 or 10 levels, so I'm really happy to be on level 4. I just did actually level 4 lesson number 1 today. So they have these grammar lessons, and each grammar lesson has a podcast with it. So like today I just listened to a level 4 podcast. Level 4 lesson 1 podcast. And what did we learn today in fact? We learned how to say like the more this, the more that in Korean. So like saying 올수록. So for example, in order to say like the more friends you have the better, you say 친구는 많을수록 좋아요. 친구는 많을수록 좋아요. So I learned how to say that today, but what I do is I listen to the podcast, and they always have a PDF to go with their podcast, and I copy down the entire PDF onto my notes. It helps me really get the information in. So like, yeah, this is like all the notes that I took today. And then what I actually just started doing today, which I really, really like to help me learn new vocab, is I will write down the new vocab that I learned in the podcast. So Talk To Me in Korean, they like teach a grammar lesson, but they also include vocabulary, obviously, in the podcast. And if I learn a new word or a new verb or something, I'll write it down. So today, I wrote down all of these new words that I learned from just that one podcast. So for example, 중요하다 means to be important, or 예문 means example sentence, or like sample sentence, sort of. 인기가 means to be popular. It's just I learned like tons of random stuff that I wrote down. So that helps me learn like new grammar and new vocabulary. Talk To Me in Korean is just awesome. And when I want to study in a more fun way with Talk To Me in Korean, I'll usually check out their YouTube videos. Their videos just make me so happy. I love it so much. I also do buy their books. So everything else that I mentioned is free, but their books are like, their books do cost money, obviously, because they're books. Well, the book that I get and work on the most are their workbooks. So I have filled out the entire level 1 workbook, level 2, and level 3, and I just started level 4 today. So after I did my whole podcast and wrote all my notes down, then I went to this. In the workbook, each lesson, grammar lesson, has like, I don't know, it's just like almost like homework or just like stuff to make sure you actually understood what you listened to. And so yeah, so I do get these. They're like $12, though they're not that expensive, and they last me a while. So that's like the books that I buy from Talk To Me in Korean specifically. So yeah. But also, I study with Talk To Me in Korean when I want to feel good about my Korean. I don't know, there's something about like the podcast and their videos that make me feel like, you know what, I'm learning and I'm getting better every time I study Korean more, and it's good. And like, I never feel really bad or like, oh, I don't know any Korean when I listen to their podcast or when I watch their videos. Like, I feel more encouraged, like, oh, I can do this. So yeah, I love Talk To Me in Korean. And that's how I kind of use their stuff. The next, a more like grammar vocab way that I study Korean is by using this textbook that I had to get for my Korean class at this university. Seogang Hangugo, Seogang Korean. I actually really don't like these books that much, but I do use them, but primarily just for vocabulary. So when you get the book, you get this little thing with it. This thing is like my favorite. In it, it shows all the vocabulary that you use in every single lesson. So what I will do before I study a lesson in here, I will look through the vocabulary, or it's called unit, not lesson, sorry. But like, I will study the vocabulary. For unit one, what I would like check all the ones that I know and all the ones that I didn't know, I would write down in my notebook. For example, I would write all the ones that I didn't know down, and then as I was going through like the unit in the book, I basically just like read through everything and make sure I understand everything and all the situations going on in it. And if there's something that I don't know, a word that I don't know, I will look at here, the ones that I wrote down with the words that I don't know, and then I'll like get it down, I'll learn it, and then go back to this. I just make sure that I understand all the vocabulary that I read in this book. So that helps me with vocabulary. So yeah, that's like what I use these books for, and then I also have to use them in my class. I found a way to make it work, but I hated the book at first. I love Talk to Me in Korean more. I think Talk to Me in Korean explains things better. But I do use the Southern Hangul for lots of vocabulary stuff, so. Yeah. So those are the two main ways that I study grammar and vocabulary. Now we're going to get to more fun ways that I study Korean. Like just everyday ways that I study Korean without having to like sit down and take notes and study, you know that. The first section that I'm going to talk about is how I practice my listening and understanding of Korean. But one thing that I've started to do recently is watch dramas without subtitles, watch K-dramas without subtitles, which can be so freaking frustrating. But usually I'll just like watch an episode of a drama that I know or a new drama. Me and Jihae did this thing once where I watched an episode of one of her favorite dramas with her in Korean without subtitles, and she kind of explained a little bit of the premise of the drama to me so that I understood kind of what was going on. And then as I watched the drama, knowing like a couple phrases and like certain words that they used helped, and knowing what Jihae told me about the plot really helped me understand what was going on in the drama, and it was so cool. So watching dramas without subtitles is really fun, and even though it can be super frustrating, it can be really helpful when it comes to listening and understanding what they're saying. It's really fun actually, and it really helps my listening skills a lot. Also, watching like, this sounds really weird, but watching the news or watching random ads that are in Korean is helpful without subtitles. Without subtitles. This is all without subtitles. Just like familiarizing yourself with the Korean without having to read any subtitles is really helpful. It's annoying, but it's helpful. This also works for when you want to watch like a V-app video or something by a K-pop star or group that's in Korean and it's live and there's no subtitles, because like you want to know so badly what they're saying, you'll be able to use all the Korean skills that you actually do know and apply it to the video, and it'll help you to understand what they're saying a little bit. And I feel like the more and more and more you watch videos without subtitles, the more you will start to rely on your head rather than subtitles on what they're saying. So even though it's been hard for me to do and really annoying, I've definitely gotten better at my listening skills, and it's super cool and exciting when the more and more you do it, the more and more you understand. It's really fun. So that's what I do for listening and understanding Korean in particular. As for reading and writing Korean, this is probably like what I do the most, to be honest. I'm better at reading and writing than I am at listening and speaking, which kind of sucks, but oh well. So for reading and writing, fun ways that I practice is I message my friends in Korean, like not all the time, but I want to start doing it more. So like Jihae and I will message each other in Korean, and Taewon and I will message each other in Korean. Sometimes my friend McCall and me will message each other in Korean. Those are the three people I message the most in Korean, and it actually really does help with my my reading skills, because when Jihae or Taewon will message me like a big chunk in Korean, I'll be able to understand through the context mostly what they're saying. And when there's like a couple words that I don't know, I'll like look it up, and it also helps me learn new vocabulary. So it's super cool. I love messaging people in Korean, even though sometimes it gives me a headache having to read all that and then have to think of a response. Responding is really hard for me to do, but I'm trying to get better, so I just need to practice a lot more. I know there are apps where you can like connect with people and do like language exchanges, sort of. I don't know those apps personally because like I don't need them because I have Korean friends, but if you don't, I'm sure you can find some apps that can help you find Koreans to message in Korean. It helps a lot, and it's a lot less scary for me than speaking, because you get to chill and think about what you need to say, and then you can write it down. And then when somebody says something in Korean, you can just like look at it and really think about what you need to write back. I don't know. I think it's really fun and a really safe, fun way to practice, especially when you're friends with them, because they're gonna understand when you make mistakes, and so it's okay. And if you don't know what they're saying, you can just be like, girl, I don't know what you're saying. What are you saying? And then they'll translate for you, and so it's good. I love messaging people in Korean. Another thing that I do is I will journal in Korean. Or I'll write, like, about my day, what I did, how I felt in Korean. That's a way that I can practice my writing skills every single day. I don't need another person. I can just write down my day and how it went. And it really helps me to formulate sentences because I'm really bad at that as well. So by writing in my journal in Korean, it helps a lot. And it helps me to notice the vocabulary that I need in my life. I don't know, writing down what I feel and what I've done in my day helps me recognize the vocabulary that I should know for my life. Does that make sense? Yeah. I also sometimes, I don't do this as often because it is very time consuming, but when I want to do more fun Korean study, is write down K-pop lyrics to like my favorite song. If there's a song that's just like so good to me and I love it so much, I'll write down the lyrics and then see like which words I understand and which ones I don't. And which ones I don't, like, I'll kind of like look it up. Then when I listen to the song over and over again, the new words that I did learn, I start to recognize them a lot in the song, so I really do learn new words. For example, in 17 song Pretty You, they say 복사, wait, 복사, the verb stem is 복사하다. It is like to copy. I don't know, guys, but as soon as I learned that, like, I remembered it and I always hear it in the song. I don't even know when they say it in the song, but they say it. So that's another fun way that I like to practice my reading and writing, is writing down K-pop lyrics and like dissecting it. And I know the grammar is not always correct, but it does help. It's just a fun way for me to get familiar with Korean. So yeah. Last section is speaking, how I practice my speaking. And this is like the worst section for me. I am terrible, terrible at speaking. So bad, guys, but I'm trying to get better. But I need to try harder. I need to get out of my comfort zone, that's for sure. So one thing that I do to practice my Korean, this sounds really funny, but to practice my speaking is when I'm by myself. Every time I try to speak aloud, but each time I speak aloud, it can only be Korean. So I speak aloud to myself in Korean so that I can become more familiar saying things in Korean so that when I'm in public, I will be more able to speak Korean. Sounds really funny, but yeah, I talk to myself in Korean sometimes when I'm by myself. I try to, and that's like a very safe way to practice speaking. Since I'm in Korea, I try to go places and order food in Korean, or like order delivery in Korean. I've done that before. Try to use it when I'm out and about and not be afraid to use it. That's really hard though, but I try to use it in my everyday life. Another thing that I'm trying to incorporate more in my life is to talk to my friends in Korean. It's still really hard for me to do. Dihae and Taewon know this, but it's really hard for me to speak Korean to them. But I'm trying to be able to do it more. I really need to improve on that, but that's another way that I'm starting to practice my speaking more, is just speaking to my friends in Korean. So that's like what I do to study Korean is all over the place, guys. All over the place. Some other tips for learning Korean that I personally like to do is like make flashcards, and I also like just listening to K-pop and Korean music in general. Oh, Noraebang with Korean music. Oh, so much fun. So guys, just like search up your song, like lyric translation, color code lyrics on YouTube, and then like sing along with it while you're reading the Korean. It's so hard, but really fun. I like doing it. I think it improves my Korean. I don't know. It's fun, but like Korean Noraebang karaoke, yeah. Like my last tip, which I need to tell myself more often, is to put yourself out of your comfort zone and like not be afraid to practice and to get better and know that you need to get better. And just like don't be afraid to mess up. Don't be afraid to like be bad at it, because you're gonna be bad at it, obviously, especially if you don't practice. So the more you practice, the more you'll get better. And as long as you're focusing on those little centimeters of getting better and better and better, then it will be good. You guys got this. Those are all of my tips. Yeah. Yeah. I really hope that this video is helpful. I'm trying to make studying Korean fun, because once it starts to become not fun to me, then it's like, I'm like, why am I learning this language? I want to make it fun, so that's why like I have all these like fun ways that I study. I try to make it fun. So yeah, I hope that you guys can have a fun time studying Korean as well. I'll put lots of links to stuff in the description on how I study and all that, and so you can check all those out. Yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video and that it was helpful for you. I'm gonna get back to studying. I've only studied for an hour and a half today, and I should probably study for a lot more. Yeah. Just don't give up, guys. Don't kill them. Poke Hajima! Woo! Okay. Alright guys, remember, life doesn't only begin at the end of your comfort zone, it also begins at the end of your culture zone. Bye guys!